States on March 23rd, 1916, and he traveled for a year, and then he decided to join the campaign against, or join forces with the NAACP and campaign against lynching, Jim Crow laws, denial of voting, and racial discrimination. He actually grew fast and got a lot of followers. And he got $10 million from all these people who followed him and believed in what he was saying. And he actually bought 2 steamships to bring Africans back to Africa, because he felt like they should go back to their homeland. He was actually elected provisional president of Africa. And he ended up going broke through all that. But this right here is Selassie.
Yeah, you're
good. There we go. And he's emperor of Ethiopia and became known as like the god in this religion. They thought of him as like the living supreme being. And Ethiopia, steered into the mainstreams of African politics. He actually became captured in 1974 and kept under house arrest until he was killed in 1975. Russians believe that it was a hoax, his death was a hoax, and he was hiding until the day of judgment. And he lives through, and then the other hawk, Rastas thinks that he lives through each individual Rastafarian. Leonard Howell was a big part of it too. The Gong is his nickname. He's a huge figure in Jamaica. Preached that the emperor was the one who came to earth. He was alleged and arrested more than 50 times. That's why this religion doesn't really have like a leader or churches. They don't really have set anything because of what happened to him. He didn't wear dreadlocks. Fun fact of today. His 6 principles: hatred towards white race, the complete superiority of the black race, revenge on white. He also, along with the emperor, to go back to Africa, and he was very into the emperor's thoughts and beliefs. this is what they teach and pass on to each other, that they, Jesus predicted the coming of the emperor. They accept the Bible as its text, but it's called the Holy Bible, maybe, something like that. And it's different from the Bible.
No.
I'll show you later on. And they wear dreadlocks to differ themselves from other groups. They emphasize smoking marijuana when they pray and they dance. They believe that there are four reincarnations from the ancient Israel tribes that were enslaved back in Babylon. And they're vegetarian. This is just like, it started right here in Kingston, the slums. Peter Garvey was born up top in the middle. And dreadlocks are biblical command for no one to cut their hair. The appearance is like a lion's mane and means strength and African, beliefs. Marijuana is considered a holy herb, used in small groups to engage in discussion while they pray. They pray before they smoke and they pray after they smoke. And Bob Marley is one of the most famous because of, he brought it to international, not just Jamaican, but religion across the globe.
4 minutes.
And then the Jahs, they're God, it's the emperor. They don't drink. The Holy Bible, Pibby, is their Bible.
Very similar to the traditional Bible.
Yeah. Yes.
That would be my question. I was gonna ask if the Holy Bible is the same.
It's the Black Man's Bible, published in 1924. All from a Christian Bible to remove all deliberate distortions that were made by white leaders.
It's very, very similar, but it's translated in African Jamaican language, style language. Other questions? We're good you didn't bring any ganja in here.
I was gonna, but I decided to.
Did you find out what I didn't want to know? I didn't think about the philosophy. God in the he actually was an Orthodox Christian, so originally when the Rastafarians came to visit him, he thought they were just crazy and tried to send them away, but he realized they weren't going to go away, but they were serious about it. And as Rastafarians